Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.3 to the public. This is available for all iOS 13 supported devices and can be downloaded by going to Software or Settings, then General, then Software Update. Once you go to Software Update, you should have the update. Now, depending on if you're on the regular iOS releases, such as iOS 13.2.3, or if you're on the beta or public beta, the size is going to vary dramatically. So if you're on the betas, expect it to be anywhere from 3 to 4 gigabytes. So on my iPhone 11 Pro Max that was on the developer beta, it was 3.95 gigabytes. If you are on the public release versions and moving over, expect it to be much smaller. It came in at 428.8 megabytes, and it should be around that size for most people. Now, if you are on the developer or public beta and you want to install it and you're not seeing the update, what you'll need to do is delete that beta profile. And I actually had to delete it in order to see the actual update. And to do that, all you do is go into your settings, go to General, scroll down until you see Profile, go into the profile and delete it. I've already deleted it, so you're not seeing it here. But if you have that, then you can go back, delete it, and then check for a software update, and it should be there. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17C54, and this particular update has a lot of bug fixes, a few new features and things like that. But the first thing is a modem update. So if you have any of these devices, you'll probably see a modem update, which just means there will be improvements to cellular connectivity and things like that. Now, if you are on the beta or beta 4 and coming to this one, you won't see a modem update. So if you're on the public version, expect an update. If you're on the latest beta, don't expect an update. Now, the other thing is there were updates for iOS 12 released for older devices, so be sure to check there as well. But let's talk about some of the new features. Now, some of the new ones have to do with screen time. So if we go into settings and then we go over to screen time here, let's find it. Can never remember where it is. There it is, screen time. And then under screen time, we have some new communication limits. So communication limits will allow you to more refine what you're allowing yourself or your children to see. It also limits things such as who your children can call, FaceTime, or message. There's also options to limit how people actually talk within your family to different contacts. So if we go into one of my contacts here, or one of my children, you can go here and now you can manage contacts. So it says manages contacts. And if I want them to have different contacts, I can tap on this, put in the screen time passcode, which I just set up quickly, and then I can add new contacts for him or delete them. It's up to you, whatever you want to do, but that's a new feature as well. Now, something that I heard quite a lot that people really don't like has to do with Animoji and Memoji stickers. And Apple has now provided a way to turn these off if you're in Messages. So within Messages, if you tap on your Emoji button there, you'll always have these Animoji or Memoji stickers. And if you want to get rid of those so they don't show up regularly, all you need to do is go into Settings, then go down to General, then go to Keyboard, and scroll all the way to the bottom of keyboard and turn off Memoji stickers. Once you turn that off, if we go back into our messages, tap on the emoji button, they're gone. So now you can turn those on or off. If they're driving you nuts, you now have that option. And I'm glad to see that Apple actually listened. And I heard this all the time that people really did not like those showing up. So I'm glad that you have the option to turn them off now. Now, the next thing they've updated has to do with Apple News. And while I never really use Apple News, if you have Apple News Plus and you're reading things such as the Wall Street Journal or other leading newspapers, there should be new layouts for them. So if you have those and maybe some of the layouts were not that great between some of the articles, there should be a new layout to make it easier to view and easier to look across. Now, there's also another update they've done so you can easily like or dislike stories. So let's go to something that's, I guess, Apple related here, and we can either like or dislike this story now easily. So that should help curate the actual news for you to be more what you like, and over time it will learn what you like and present you more news that you would enjoy as opposed to things you don't care about. Now, the next thing has to do with stocks. So if we go into the stocks app here, let me find it. And within Stocks, stories from Apple News are now available in Canada in English and French. So any of these Apple News stories that are down here that are related to Stocks are now available in Canada in English and French. Also, you can continue reading with links to related stories or more stories from the same publication. So maybe you were in Apple News and you were looking at some of these stories. You can go into this story here, go back to Apple News, and they'll resume and be concurrent to whatever you're looking at currently. And then there's also breaking and developing labels for top stories. So you'll see top stories. If it's breaking news, you'll see that, or developing news, you'll see that as well. Now within the camera, they've added a new feature or photos. If we record a video, so let's just record a quick video. We'll record a video of what we have down here, maybe my keyboard in the background, things like that. We've got a 6-second video clip. If we go into this clip, we can go into this within photos as well, and then we hit edit, and then maybe we trim this clip a little bit. We'll just remove the end of it. We hit done. We can now save the video or save the video as a new clip. So it's non-destructive editing. So you can do either or now, and it's just a nice little feature. So if you don't want to ruin the initial clip, you'll have this option now. So it's really nice. They've just added that. Now they've also added support for something you don't really see, but they've added support for NFC, USB, and Lightning FIDO2 compliant security keys within Safari. So if you use a security key for two-factor authentication, maybe you're using one for Google, their Titan security key, or something else, you'll now have the ability to use it within Safari. So if you go to, say, Google and you want to log into it, you can use it in the browser itself instead of having to exit and go to a separate app. So that's something new. Now, there are some new features, but let's go over a couple things they've fixed first as far as the Mail app. If we go into Mail, and within Mail, you'll see I don't have anything in this particular inbox, but they've fixed an issue in Mail that prevented downloading new messages. So if you weren't seeing new messages coming in or they were really slow to come in, that should be fixed as well. Now, they've also addressed an issue that prevented deleting messages if you were using Gmail. So maybe you had your Gmail account set up in here and you were deleting a bunch of messages and they just wouldn't delete. I've heard this quite a bit, actually. It should be fixed now. And then finally, within Mail, it resolves an issue that could cause incorrect characters to display in messages and duplication of sent messages, specifically in exchange accounts. Now, another thing they've fixed is maybe we're in a note here and we want to tap on something and maybe use the space bar as our cursor. Well, there was a bug where the cursor wouldn't move after you've done this. They've now fixed that with this update. So that's something that's really nice. Now, something I've heard a lot is maybe you take a screenshot and then you want to send this screenshot to a friend through iMessage and it shows up blurry for them. That has now been resolved. So that's something they've fixed. If you send along a screenshot, it shouldn't be blurry. I've heard this from the beginning of iOS 13 beta, so I'm glad they finally fixed that. It also fixes an issue when maybe you took a screenshot and then you go into that screenshot and then maybe you mark it up. We'll just say hi here, and then you want to save this. We hit done and you save to photos. If it wasn't saving to photos before, it will save now. They've fixed that in this update. They've also fixed an issue with voice memo recording. So let's go into that. And if you're in a voice memo and you were actually trying to share this voice memo with another app and it wasn't showing up, that should now be resolved as well. So they're fixing a lot of bugs in this particular update. It also fixes an issue where the missed call badge on the phone may not clear. So maybe you had a call with your phone app and it says number 1 or 2, and you know that you don't have anything there. It should now show that properly instead of leaving that little mark there to let you know you have a call. So thankfully they fixed that. Those little things like these numbers drive me nuts. So I'm glad to see they fixed that. They've also fixed an issue when it comes to cellular data. When you go into settings and then cellular, it would show that cellular data was off, even though it wasn't really off. So they've fixed that in this update. They've also fixed an issue that prevented turning off dark mode if you had smart invert enabled. So maybe you were using smart invert to kind of show dark mode, and then you went to turn it on or off. Well, they've now fixed that and it should work properly. And then finally, if you're using a wireless charger and it wasn't charging at the correct rate, it should now charge properly with wireless chargers. So if you have an iPhone 8 Plus or newer with wireless charging, and maybe you have a 7.5 watt or faster wireless charger and it wasn't charging properly, that should now work properly. So all of those things have been fixed now. Now they did update an icon for the Apple Watch. So if we go to this folder, the Apple Watch here, this icon now has a ring around the actual dial. So on the dial of my Series 4 Apple Watch here, you'll see there's a little ring that signifies that it's a cellular model. They've now updated the icon to reflect the exact same thing. So not a huge change, but something to note. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is battery. So those were all of the fixes and changes and updates. Battery life on the betas has actually been good for most people and then bad for others. So it's hard to say if it's going to be great for you. On my battery life over the course of beta 1 through beta 4, you'll see over the past few days, this is my usage today, 2 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 3 minutes of screen off time. I have 74% of my battery life left. So if we extrapolate that out times 4, we get about 10 hours of screen on time, give or take, depending on what you're doing. So that's pretty good battery life. That's pretty typical for an 11 Pro Max, but using it all day takes time, of course, and it will take a few days to know for sure how great battery life is or how bad it is. So be sure to check back for the follow-up for that. Now, performance on iOS 13.3 should be improved or very smooth for most people. During the betas, it was great. And this is the iPhone 6S Plus, so one of the older devices. But if I go into something like weather, you'll see that was already there. The App Store, it's nice and smooth to scroll. If we go into settings, we should see the same thing. So everything's nice and fluid and fast. And then maybe go into music here. We can scroll through. It's just nice to use this particular update. It feels like they've fixed a lot of things as far as stuttering and things like that. The same is true on an older device like the iPhone SE, although this should be nice and fast for most people. Again, going into things like settings or music, everything's just nice and fast. And that's the first time I've opened music since installing this update. Now, when it comes to iPad OS, there were no changes other than what I already mentioned. So all of those same fixes carry across to iPad, and it should work well for you. This is one of the oldest supported iPads that's supported by iPad OS 13.3. And you'll see again, everything's fluid. That's the first time I've opened settings since restoring this or since installing this. And let's go into the iTunes store, see how it loads. There we go. So not bad, especially given its age and lack of amount of RAM. And speaking of RAM, RAM management seems to be pretty good in these updates. So for most people, RAM management should be fine. Apps should not be reloading too much. That's the first time I've opened YouTube, and that may take a moment. But most of the time, things do not reload like they did before. So you should have better RAM management as well. Now, I did run a Geekbench on all of these devices just to give you an idea what they're like. Now, I did run them right after installing the update, so some of these numbers probably will improve over the next day or so. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. And I am using Geekbench 5, so these numbers will be a little bit low compared to someone that's using Geekbench 4. 5 is really what you should be using at this point. So let's go down to today, and you'll see on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,331 for single core, 3,272 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, or we'll go back here, you'll see it's okay. The multi-core score is a little bit lower than before, but again, I would expect this to come up a little bit. The single core is a little bit better. So after a few days of use or a day or so, I would expect these numbers to come up after it's done doing all of its background tasks. Now let's take a look at all of these devices so you can compare yours against them. From left to right, we have the iPad Air 2, then we have the iPhone SE, the iPhone 6S Plus, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this should give you a general idea of what your scores will be like. Again, these numbers could go up over the next day or so. That's it for iOS 13.3. Now, as far as iOS 13.4 betas, we may see them this week if Apple keeps with what they've been doing with iOS 13, but maybe they'll give us a little bit of a break since we're on the holiday season and we won't see it until the new year. It's really hard to say at this point, but if they keep with what they've been doing, we should see it this week or early next week. But let me know what you think in the comments below. Now, as far as features and things, I wouldn't expect anything major with the next versions unless they're little tweaks and things like that to do with maybe some updates with other devices. And Apple also updated the Apple TV, the HomePod, macOS, and watchOS as well. The watch has nothing new in it, but all of those things have been updated today. So if you have those devices, go ahead and install those as well. Now be sure to check back in a few days for a follow-up. I'll do a poll and everything like that, like I normally do. And if you found anything else new that I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Oh, and if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.